and here to make us a foolproof rack of lamb with kalamata, olives, feta, and eggplant, please welcome back the executive chef of LA's Bourbon Steak at the Americana, our good friend, Kyle Johnson. Welcome back.
Thank you so much.
I'm so excited to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me back.
So when you say foolproof and rack of lamb in the same sentence, I'm kind of confused because when you look at a rack of lamb, a lot of people are very intimidated. This is something that you usually is served to at a restaurant that you don't make at home because it kind of is tough, no?
That's correct. And when I started cooking, I was intimidated as well. But you know what? It's really easy. It's really approachable. Any home cook can do it 100%. So, I'm fully confident in everyone out there that they can do this.
Okay.
Especially after this segment.
Yeah. So you guys dig in. Okay. Kim, Shirley, Ken, and Cameron are at the counter. And Ken is actually rolling up his sleeves.
I like that.
I was like, what are you doing over there, Ken? All right. So don't be intimidated by the big piece of meat with all the bones coming out. You're going to show us how to do this easily.
Right. So what we've done, we've taken this rack of lamb that we've gotten out of your local butcher or your local market, and we've already started to render this out a little bit. Previous to this, we took a little salt and cracked black pepper, seasoned up nice, let it sit for about 5 minutes so the salt and pepper can absorb in there. And then we're just slowly rendering out the fats on the fat cap side down in this cast iron skillet.
With olive oil?
This right here was actually like a canola oil because olive oil has a very low smoke point.
Right.
So this is a canola neutral-based oil, not a lot of imparting flavors because we're going to impart a ton of other flavors.
But could you use it instead of canola, another sort of oil that was high smoke point?
Yeah, so nut oils are very high smoke point oils, right? Okay. So what we have here is it's searing, and what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to turn this now that it's got nice and golden brown here on this side.
Wow. Okay. How long would we leave it on one side?
Okay, so that depends on the heat of your stove, but what you're really looking for in one of those indicators is just when it's down like so, I always look at the side and you can start to see right here that golden brown color. Oh, yeah. And we just flip it. I've had this on low.
Okay.
The lowest setting really that this can go, and it's been about 8 minutes that we've seared this, right?
Okay, so you're cooking it low and slow.
Yeah, low and slow is the way to go. Always with cooking, you don't want to seize proteins, you don't want to throw things into a hot oven. And once this is all nice and caramelized up on both sides, I just flip it down like so. The bone can hang off the pan just a little bit.
So they don't burn.
Yeah, and then we're going to take a little bit of butter. And we're gonna baste like a professional chef in the kitchens. You've probably seen this.
Like a professional chef. Yeah. He is a professional.
Yeah, right.
Right, so we're gonna add this butter. And you can see while it's low, it's not gonna burn the butter.
Which I found really interesting because when I was reading this recipe, I said, oh my gosh, he puts the butter in at the beginning and begins to baste, which can be super tricky because it can go from brown butter to burned butter very quickly.
And you don't wanna burn the butter. And what happens when you're doing this is the milk solids toast a little and it gives a nuttiness and a depth of flavor into that. So what we're gonna do is we tilt the pan just slightly down like so, and we take our spoon and we just baste over the top of that.
Wow, isn't that beautiful?
And one of my favorite things to do at home, honestly, is just rosemary is beautiful. And your entire house as this rosemary toast is really gonna smell, especially in the winter time. You got a fire going, a glass of red wine.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's a really, really wonderful evening.
And you're setting the scene.
Yeah, and your house will smell wonderful. I guarantee it. And then we just gently baste. You want to baste away from you. Obviously, you don't want to bring hot oil towards you. Okay. And we just slowly just baste this over and over again. You could actually cook the meat all the way to the desired temperature just by doing this.
And you could cook it just on the stovetop the entire time, but you then put it in the oven for a few minutes, correct?
Correct. So what I'm going to do, and I like taking the butter here, and I like kind of drizzling it over the rosemary. You can take the rosemary and put it on top.
Kyle.
And then just baste that. And you can just see the rosemary just kind of glistens with that butter, and it's toasting those herbs and imparting flavor all over this rack of lamb.
How beautiful is that?
Right? So now that we've basted this nicely, I take the herbs and I just lay the herbs on top of the lamb and not in the pan, not to burn those herbs.
Okay. Can I, is this clearly not burning your hand?
No, this it was low. It actually was this very low.
Here you go.
100%. This isn't
for. I noticed that just now.
Okay, but when you put it in the oven and you pull it out, 100%, it's
right.
Gonna be.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So this is actually is not very hot because we cooked really, really, really low.
Okay. Okay,
and I don't have those hardened chef hands. I do, but
no,
it's not hot, right?
All right. So we put it in for how long? Would you put this in now?
So we're gonna put it in for about 10 minutes.
At what temperature?
About 350 to 375.
Okay.
And then when it's out, we're gonna have our rack of lamb here that has been roasting for about 10 minutes. I prefer a medium of rack of lamb.
As opposed to medium rare?
Yeah, absolutely. To cook it a little bit longer. This is a Colorado rack of lamb. So the flavor is mild. Mm. It's really, you know, mint jelly is the classic accompaniment, right?
Sure.
That was for mutton. That was for old world days.
But when it was very gamey.
Very gamey. Yeah. This is very subtle. It just has a really nice lamb flavor.
Very nice.
And if you were, so for medium, how long would you cook it? Would you cook it for maybe then 18 minutes for medium?
Yes.
As opposed to 10 to 12 for
absolutely.
Medium rare?
And you know, you really need to take into consideration your oven. I have beautiful ovens at work that cook things very quickly, and then I go home and I'm like, oh, this is not hot enough, and things do take a little bit.
Right.
I believe in thermometers and just taking a probe and getting it to about 132 degrees for medium rare.
Okay, now here's the magic. You're gonna cut this guy in half, right? So again,
yes.
This can get tricky.
Yeah, so there are bones here, and you want to make sure that you don't cut through those bones. So I just grabbed the rack here, and then you want to go through just like so.
Wow, that was perfect. That was not tricky at all.
So no.
Because every time I try to go through it, I get that little sinewy thing, and I can't. Do you know what I'm talking
about? Yes, absolutely. And it's really in those bones right there, and you have to kind of wiggle your knife in through those bones.
Okay.
And you don't necessarily have to cut it in half either. You can just go in with fork and knife and get it.
All right. So now you're serving this with a beautiful olive puree.
Yeah, so this is a Kalamata olive puree that we just pureed in a Vitamix, and we just take a little line and put it down like so. I do like layering flavors of olives. We have a little roasted eggplant here with some winter citrus. Citrus is beautiful right now. And some fresh Kalamata olives that we have just cut up, just like so. And we just arrange them on the plate. There's real no
beautiful.
Real right or wrong way to do this and where they lie.
And then you're also adding something called olive powder, which I've never heard of.
So we have a little olive oil powder. So it's just olive oil and a tapioca starch. It's a fun little chef secret recipe tip. And it's pretty easy to do in a food processor and olive oil.
Just olive oil and tapioca?
Tapioca starch, yep, and olive oil. And you just drizzle it in a food processor.
Really good.
We lay this down, and this is different notes of the olive. And it's kind of fun for the winter. It looks like snow. I like to add a little bit of feta as this blends in with the olive oil powder. And then you get these little bursts of olive oil and the feta. And you don't really, and it kind of tricks your senses.
Yeah. What's happening?
That's crazy.
And then, of course, your microgreen salad.
That's correct. So we have a lavender mint with torn mint and dill. And then I just like to kind of throw this all around on top. Again, it kind of looks like a...
It's amazing. Yeah. Just watching you cook and plate is so wonderful and soothing.
It's the talent.
You're an artist.
Thank you.
Are you going to let Debbie have a little taste? What do you think,
Deb? 100%.
Oh,
I know she's Greek, and she's south of Greece, and she's ready to dig into this.
I mean, the lamb, I was like, he's made this just for me.
Yes, absolutely. Let me know what you think.
Oh, boy, this was amazing.
I know you've been waiting.
And again, you know, you shouldn't be intimidated when making this recipe whatsoever. It's really easy to do. And, you know, if you mess up your mistakes in cooking, the best thing is you get to eat it.
Yeah.
That's
right.
And it's practice, and it's, you know,
she's
it's,
so
it's
happy
not meant
right
to be
now.
Kyle,
a hard recipe.
She's happy.
It's not, and as always, thank you so much. This was absolutely delicious, and evidence is all of us here and Debbie freaking out right there having a taste.